Very good morning, students. So I welcome you back to class 7th literature, and we will continue with our poem The Road Not Taken. We have already discussed the first two paragraphs of the poem, so we will see what happens next. We saw in the first two paragraphs that how the poet was standing on a road and then he had to make a choice. Two roads were diverging, they were separating in two directions in the forest, and he had to choose one. So we will see that what happens, and we saw that he chose the second one because he wanted to make a difference, because he felt that the second path was less traveled by less people, so he decided to take the second path. Now we'll see what happens next in the poem. We'll have a recitation of the poem first, so everyone I hope should recite the poem. And both that morning equally lay in leaves, no step had trodden black. Oh, I kept the first for another day, yet knowing how way leads on to way, I doubted if I should ever come back. I shall be telling this with a sigh, somewhere ages and ages hence. Two roads diverged in a yellow wood, and I took the one less traveled by, and that has made all the difference. So we saw that how the poet chooses his path, and you will see, and he's saying, and both that morning equally lay. It's during the morning when he had to make choice, he felt that both the roads were similar, they equally lay in the forest. And in leaves no step had trodden black. He's telling, he saw the leaves, the grasses which were there, the leaves which were there. He felt that no one has moved on those grasses because it was still green in color. No steps had trodden. Meaning of trodden means crushed or pressed. So he felt that no one has crushed the leaves and they have not turned black in color. So he's telling they are still green in color. So he felt that in the morning no one has walked through both those roads. Oh, I kept the first for another day. So we saw that he took the second road. So he's telling, he's trying to feel sorry that he could not take the first road. So he's telling, I kept the first for another day. So he's telling, I left the first path because I thought the next day I will travel that. Yet knowing how way leads on to way. He's telling, I know very well that one way will lead to some other way. I'm not going to come back and I'm not going to move on the first path again. So he's telling, although I was knowing that how way leads on to another way, I doubted if I should ever come back. He's telling, I was pretty sure that I'm not going to return back to the first path. So he's telling, I doubted if I should ever come back. So he had doubt that he would not return back to the choice where he made, to the place where he made the choice. So in life also this happens. When we get options, we have to make choice, and most probably when you make a choice, it's difficult to return back and change your choice. So whenever you're making choice, you should be very sure that yes, I'm going to take this path and I will move ahead on that. Next paragraph you will see, I shall be telling this with a sigh, somewhere ages and ages hence. He's telling, after some ages means he's telling after long time, I will be telling this with a sigh. Sigh means a sense of relief. Or we can say, he's telling, I will take a deep breath and with a sense of relief, after a long time, I would be telling to my future generations that somewhere ages and ages hence, two roads diverged in a wood. He's telling, somewhere long time back, I had two options, two roads were there and they were separating in two directions in the forest, and I took the one less traveled. And he's telling, I'll be telling with everyone that I took that road which was less traveled, and what I am today, and that has made all the difference. He's telling, and what I am today is because of the road which I chose that time. So he is telling, maybe in future, when I take this road in future, I'll be telling my generations, see that a long time back I had to make choice and I took the second path. And whatever I am today, that whatever difference is there, whatever I am today is because of the choice which I made. So this is what our poem says. Now in life also what happens, we have to make choices. A road symbolizes here, road symbolizes our life, and the path which we did not choose, the path which we do not choose is the road we have not taken. It describes his feelings about the choice that he had left in the past. The path we choose decides our future and our destination. The poet wants to give a message that the choice has an impact on the future. So whatever choices we make today, it has impact on the future, and we have to move ahead on that choice, because we cannot change our choices. We have to move ahead, and there may be obstacles, but we have to fight them and we have to move ahead. Similarly, students, you should also be very wise while making choices. When you make choices, be very wise and decide what you have to do or what you have not to do in your lives, because what choices you make today will absolutely affect your future. So be wise in making choices. There will be instances in life where you have to make choices, and you have to be very wise to make choices which will lead to beautiful destinations. So this is the end of our poem. We have seen how the poet describes and he symbolizes the road to the life. Now one thing I would like to discuss with you. Here we in the poem, there on page number 11 in your book, it has been told that what is the rhyming scheme of your poem. Now I'd like to tell you how we take out the rhyming scheme of our poem. In your book page number 11, it's telling the rhyming scheme of your poem is A, B, A, A, B. Everyone will look into that page and we will see how we take out the rhyming scheme of any poem. Okay, so first of all, we take this paragraph, the third paragraph of our poem. And if you read the first line of your poem, and we see the last word of every line. We see the last word of every line. And if we see the last word of the first line of this paragraph, lay. Lay, and we write it as A. We symbolize it as A. Then we take the second line. The second line last word is black. Now black is not rhyming with lay. So we'll give it another name, B. Now we see the third line. Third line ends with day. Now day is rhyming with lay. So we will give day as also A. Now the last word of fourth line is way. Now way is rhyming with day and lay. So this also we mark it as A. Now the last, yes, the paragraph 5 lines, the last line, it has back. So back is rhyming with black. So we are going to mark it as B. So in each paragraph we will see what is our rhyming. Our rhyming is A, B, A, A, B. So what is the rhyming scheme of this poem? Rhyming scheme of this poem is A, B, A, A, B. And if you see the last paragraph, we will also get the same thing. Psi, we take it as A, hence we take it as B. Psi and I and by. So all three are rhyming, so we give them name A. And the last one, if you see, hence and difference, so we give it as B. Now in this line also, in this paragraph also, we see A, B, A, A, B. So the rhyming scheme of this poem is A, B, A, A, B. I hope everyone knows how to take out the rhyme of the poem. And so we end up our poem here, and we'll meet in the next video. Thank you very much.